Robert Pattinson is confirmed to play the Caped Crusader. So will we see our bats dance with this devil in the pale moonlight? On this IMDbrief, we break down how Pattinson and Joaquin Phoenix could square off as Batman and Joker.
How long have you been 17?
A while.
Robert Pattinson has come a long way from those twihard days of yore, and lately he's been delivering brilliant and surprising performances in the very unwestern Damsel, in slow burn dark fantasy The Lighthouse, and an electrifying crime gone wrong thriller Good Time.
Don't be confused. It's just gonna make it worse for me.
He'll bring that dogged craftsmanship to Matt Reeves' The Batman, which is still swirling with rumors about plot, release, and villains ranging from 2 to 6. But it seems that Reeves and Pattinson are set to reboot Bruce Wayne in the 1990s with a whole lot of Alfred.
Can I persuade you to take a sandwich with you, sir?
I'll get drive-thru.
Not that 90s and not that Alfred. This bat will strike a darker, noirish tone, taking influence from Alfred Hitchcock, which would pair perfectly with Frank Miller's graphic novel, Year One.
Fairy tales and ghost stories.
One misses the days when one's biggest concerns were exploding wind-up penguins.
Director Darren Aronofsky worked on a Year One adaptation in the early 2000s and even approached Christian Bale, which played a part in how he eventually wound up as Bruce Wayne in Christopher Nolan's trilogy of films. But Aronofsky also considered another actor to top-line his Batman film, Joaquin Phoenix.
I used to think that my life was a tragedy. Now I realize it's a comedy.
What would be the odds that over a decade later, Phoenix would instead become the Caped Crusader's deadliest foe? Although director Todd Phillips hinted that this Joker will be a one-off in a timeline separate from the current DCEU, perhaps it's just another coincidence that Joker takes place in 1981, the same year that Batman v Superman established as the death of Bruce's parents.
Martha.
If we follow Pattinson's first 365 days on the job, or his year one, as an early 30s Bruce, who finds allies in a newly transferred officer Jim Gordon and assistant DA Harvey Dent, while getting caught in the crossfire of a gang war and fending off a pre-Catwoman Selina Kyle, the film could tee up a long Halloween.
They may have trouble adapting to their new environment.
Writer Jeff Loeb continued Miller's Year One in the 13-issue The Long Halloween, a complex detective story about Batman hunting the holiday killer and Harvey Dent's origin as Two-Face.
It's not about what I want. It's about what's fair!
Joker's role may have been minor in the grand scope of Long Halloween, but his battle with the Bat in Gotham Square could spur a final showdown for a third film that perhaps takes notes from Miller's The Dark Knight Returns, or even Alan Moore's The Killing Joke.
Well, what are you waiting for? Kick the hell out of me and get your standing ovation.
All of these comics have influenced previous Bat films, but every filmmaker veered far from the source material to put their indelible stamp on the franchise. Perhaps Pattinson, Phoenix, and Reeves will find a way to bring Batman back home to the Wayne Manor of the comic books.
That wasn't exactly what I had in mind when I said I wanted to inspire people.
For more Caped Crusader tales, stay tuned to imdb.com/imdbrief.
See you next week. Same bat time, same bat station.